Beloved one, I hope you are doing well. I want us to take a short reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 127. It says, if God's grace doesn't help the builders, they will labor in vain to build a house. If God's mercy doesn't protect the city, all the sentries will circle it in vain. It's really a senseless to work so hard from morning till late at night, toiling to make a living for fear of not having enough. Now God can provide. I want you to see this. It says God can provide for his devoted lovers even while they sleep. Now this tells us of the great things that we enjoy anytime we come into God's presence. It tells us of the blessings we enjoy anytime we are with God. And then we can do this through prayer, through the word of God, and even as we are about listening to that. So I want us to do something. We are going to like this video. So then please hit on the like button if you have not done so. This helps YouTube recommend this video out there to anyone, so everyone can have access to it. Also, by doing this, you help in the spread of the gospel and of the good work of this channel. Then don't forget to leave a comment in that comment section. Hit on that subscribe button if you haven't done so and you are new here. And then get on to the notification bell and do us the favor of tapping on it too. You are blessed.
Can you just hold hands with someone and begin to pray in the spirit? Just hold hands with someone and begin to pray in the spirit. Hold hands with someone and begin to pray in the spirit. Just make contact. Jaka 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 jaka. Oh, like a bride waiting for her groom, even so come, even so come, even so come. Kaparakota shaprandigera tusata. Shekete pretekete berekete praskata barada barada bar. Bina nama nama sota nama 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 nama. Jena mana mosu nana mani nana nama nama. Jena na 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 Keep praying. There is something that will lead heaven to this place. Keep praying. Keep praying. Keep praying. Rakata parada balada 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 Shakapakata praskata parada balada balada da 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 da. Keep praying, don't be tired. Hallelujah. We're going to pray one more time. If you are sick in your body, just lay your hands there. There is a strong healing anointing in this place right now. You are sick anywhere in your body, lay your hands. Lay your hands. I see the power of God about to touch people in a few minutes. Miracles of healing. The Lord is healing migraine headache right now. There are people suffering from intense migraine headache. The power of God is touching you right now. Right now, I'm seeing a lady having severe, like menstrual cramps. Severe menstrual cramps. Right now, as I speak, the power of God is touching. That pain leaves right now. There is a spirit that has been walking with a lady. You literally feel as if there is a man walking by your side. That spirit is leaving you right now. by the power of the Holy Ghost. That spirit is leaving you right now. This is Zion, the city of the Lord. There's someone, your voice, for a while your voice has been unable to be clear. It's like there's something hooking you. You're going to feel like fire on your throat right now. Right now, and your voice will come back to normal. Right now. Right now, hotness of the body. That's what the Lord is telling me. Father, we give you all the glory. Hotness of the body. Hotness of the body is living right now. There is someone, you brought your mother. Your mother is in this place. She's been unable to sleep for a long time. She can't even sleep. But right now, the power of God is coming upon her. And that devil is giving way right now. 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 There's someone, you have a boil, like a boil in your nose, right inside your nose. The power of God is touching it. Not only will it be healed, it will disappear right away. You will touch it and you will not feel anything. Right now, the Lord is touching. The Lord is touching. The Lord is touching. I'm seeing a river in the realm of the spirit. That's what I'm seeing flowing into this place. A river. It's a river of miracles. Many will be swept by that river. It's a river that flows from the love and the throne of God. It's a river bringing healing. Bringing healing. Bringing healing. There are miracles going on. Healing miracles. Zekate paratos shabakarianda kapros katos kepres katos shapres katos sepatari katos abaria. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a spectacular miracle that the Lord wants to do for many people. Hallelujah. I'm seeing a group of people in the realm of the spirit. You used to hear God in profound dimensions, but from the beginning of this year, something happened to your hearing. And it's an attack from the gate of hell. Now please pay attention. I'm speaking by the spirit. It's an attack from darkness upon your hearing. And it's like something has closed you. Some of you don't even know you are part of it. I'm about to pray for you. Because that prophetic dimension, you need it to hear what I want to teach you tonight. You need it. There are some dimensions of spiritual communication that you cannot understand it scientifically. And the Lord is asking me to pray. Therefore, Father, I stretch my hands on your people. Every gate of the prophetic that has been closed. Every gate. The hearing ear, let that grace be released. Right now. The hearing ear. Sata kaparata. Many of you will hear the sound of angels instantly. Instantly. Inside, outside. Those following on our social media platform. The Lord is opening. The Lord is opening prophetic dimensions. The hearing of the spirit. Authentic hearing. Not nonsense. An authentic hearing. Shakataba. Sheketekata. Rakatapakotosia. For some of you, it is restoration. 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 What happened to your hearing that you no longer hear the sounds of the spirit? Like fire is coming on the ears of people. Fire falling on people. Fire. A restoration of hearing. A restoration of hearing. A restoration of hearing. Lift your hands. There are people here, your dreams used to be prophetic, but it was hijacked. And my God, something is happening to your spirit man. The hand of God is coming upon your spirit man. The hand of God coming upon your spirit man. Right now. Dreams. Shaka patata. Strange dreams. Where you will understand the counsel of God. In the visions of the night. The counsel of God. In the visions of the night. The counsel of God. In the visions of the night. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The last thing I'll pray for before we sit down is sensitivity. Listen, let me tell you. If you lack sensitivity in this season and in this time, you will never be able to be in sync with what God is saying. Sensitivity is like breathing in the realm of the spirit. To be able to understand the impulses of the spirit and align yourself with what the spirit is doing and saying. He said the sons of Issachar, they had an understanding of the time and they knew what Israel ought to do. I want to pray for you. There is a grace that makes men sensitive. Many of us used to be sensitive, especially our sisters. Something has happened to your sensitivity. But in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. This is a mountain of the Lord's house where grace is sufficient. Grace is sufficient. Right now, I stretch my hands. May that grace begin to fall on men and women. Let it fall, let it fall. Sensitivity, discernment, sensitivity, discernment, sensitivity, discernment to the speakings of the spirit, sensitivity, discernment to the speakings of the spirit.
Mighty on your throne, mighty on your throne, you were mighty on your throne.
Hey,
mighty on your throne, you were mighty in this throne. Mighty on your throne, you were mighty on your throne. Mighty on your throne, you were mighty on your throne. Mighty on your throne, you are mighty on your throne. Mighty in my life, mighty in my life, you are mighty in my life.
Father, we pray that you go ahead and do everything you intend for us to experience tonight. Right beyond our dimensions, right beyond our perceptions, right beyond our yieldedness. I know, God, I pray that you activate strange things in the lives of people. Strange things in the life of people. Please sit down carefully if you can. Tonight will be a night of strange impartations. If you can't, just sit down and let your heart be open, let your spirit be sensitive, no carelessness, no distraction. Please, Koinonia is a place of impartation. You need impartation to rise and step into your prophetic destiny. There are times that certain things need to be activated. Nothing can cover for noise and stories. You must come into the reality of certain experiences, and impartation is one of the platforms that can bring you into those realities. Once again, I welcome everyone. This is Koinonia. Tonight is a night of strange impartations. And there is a reason why God is doing it. There is a reason why God is bringing us to this dimension of impartations. It's not just for nothing. Listen, in the course of my teaching, I'll be very brief tonight. But in the course of my teachings, there will be different kinds of anointings just coming in. You get this in Koinonia. Koinonia is a place where things are activated. And so when your word comes, it will come upon you. Yours is just to be sensitive. As I teach, there will be dispensing of graces. Dispensing of graces. Be sensitive. Don't just hear what I'm saying. A time will come. Yours will come upon you.
So it's going to be a noisy meeting. Don't worry. You will hear what I'm saying. But as I teach, people will receive things. Will receive things. Inside, outside, everywhere. You will receive things.
Shabratu sakuratu saprita shidahari. Dembroto subrakatabaria.
Listen. The church must pay the price for a genuine anointing that will really be able to bring God to the scene. The church must pay the price for a genuine, authentic anointing that will be able to bring true results for people. The only way we can become a revelation of the Christ, I'm telling you this, is to contend for a dimension in the spirit that affords us the privilege of hosting superior dimensions of the presence and the power of God. Talk is cheap. It's easy to make a lot of noise in the body of Christ. It's easy to stand upon many doctrinal and theological dissertations, communicating the things that we believe should be. But in the final analysis, people need to experience the reality of the kingdom. And I think this is where a lot of we pastors have not done justice for people. A lot of us are speaking prophets. A lot of us are mighty pastors and apostles and prophets and bishops. We can communicate spiritual reality. But the challenge is when it comes to the practical demonstration of the essence of our communication. We try to create all kinds of theological excuses. So there are so many things we teach that God is. There are so many things we teach that God can do. There are so many realities we whet the appetite of God's people by opening them up to the possibilities that can be in the spirit. But it is so frustrating when people's appetites are to the apex, yet we sustain the power and the life to experientially draw them into those experiences. So we teach on healing. We teach on different kinds of healing, different dimensions of healing. And then in the final analysis, the sick person still goes back sick. The cancer patient still goes back with their cancers. We are happy about dispensing theologically arranged communications. But the Bible says, listen, the Bible tells us that the gospel, listen, is not just about the excellency of speech, right? But the demonstration of power, to the end that the faith of people will not be founded upon the wisdom of men, but upon the power of God. No matter what you say about God, if you cannot bring him to the scene for me to relate with his might, you have wasted my time. I may applaud you for your intelligence and your ability to be flawless in your research, but let me tell you something. In the final analysis, people need to be transformed. Demons are not a theory, they are real. Sicknesses are not a theory, they are real. Oppression is not a theory, it is real. Poverty is not a theory, it is real. Only preaching largely are theories.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God.
Hallelujah. The Lord showed me a vision a few days ago. And in that vision, I saw so many people in the church weary and tired. That's what I saw in the vision. Including pastors. I saw people seated and stranded. No message. Because everything to be preached have been preached. I saw members frustrated and humiliated. And the Lord began to reveal to me that it is a strategy. Please pay attention. It's a prophetic teaching tonight. It's a strategy by the kingdom of darkness. Because when you study, when you listen to my teaching, why revivals fail, I shared with you, dear, a strategy with which Satan uses to defeat many believers. Satan will never strike you at your point of strength. He knows that all men are human. Although we are divine, there is a human component to us. So the moment you are doing the work of the kingdom, advancing the purposes of the kingdom, fervent in prayer, strong in the word, the devil will not attack you. He knows that there is one thing that is common to all men. It's called exhaustion. The reality of our humanity. That no matter how powerful you are, no matter how anointed you are, a time must come when the reality of your humanity will meet up with you. It is at that point that men are separated from the voice. It is at that point that only those who sustain a system in the spirit to continue will stand. I saw that vision. I saw faces I recognized, and I could not believe that such great men could be weary. Now, you see, a man of God can be weary and you will not know. Because don't mistake the grace upon a man to dispense truth and his personal growth and progress. They are two different things. I can be as dry and weary as whatever, but when I stand upon this pulpit, the anointing that comes with my office will make me act so flawless you will not know that I'm at the verge of giving up. Are we together? Most times we mistake the grace and the unction that accompanies the office of a man to mean that because that grace looks ever fresh, ever flowing in power, that it necessarily means the person is highly motivated and happy. No, there are times I've been so tired, physically tired, going for meetings, and I can sometimes it looks like I can't stand for 15 minutes, but the moment I hold that mic, I no longer become Joshua Selman. An apostolic anointing comes and I can stand for hours. Now, you may mistake my strength to mean that I am not weak. Do you know sometimes when I get back home, even to eat becomes a problem? Are we together? So I saw weariness in that vision. I saw many people gassing out in prayer, literally like a meter, just diminishing. I saw people gassing out in their word level. And one of the areas that I saw people crying is the area of not getting results financially and otherwise. It was frustrating people. I saw quarrels between people, fathers, mothers, different people. I saw pastors fighting themselves. And I was wondering, what is the meaning of all this nonsense? And the Lord told me, this is what the devil wants to bring. He's taking advantage of the economic tide that is sweeping the nations as a tool, and he wants to wreak havoc in the lives of people. Are we together? Part of the advantages of a true apostolic ministry is to have an eye that sees and the ability to perceive the impulses of the spirit per time and communicate to people the realities that are the emphasis of God for that moment. That's why we pray for perception. Because there are many of us, if your perception were alive, you would have picked the signal. Let me tell you something. It's important to gauge your spiritual growth. Don't let men clap you into spiritual mediocrity. What are you an MOG for when you cannot perceive the impulses of the spirit? What are you a campus fellowship president for, or a pastor or an apostle, when the things of the spirit happen? Discussions are going on in the realm of the spirit and your presence cannot be registered because you have not sustained an ability to rise beyond your flesh and understand the speakings of the spirit. Hallelujah. Ministry is not all about preaching, but the ability to perceive the impulses of people. When God makes you a leader, he commits unto you the destinies of people. It's your responsibility now to be in sync with the spirit. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 1 says, I will stand upon my watch and I will set myself upon the tower. It says, and I will see what the Lord will say. Not hear what he will say. See, perceive, conceive. what he's saying. When I saw this, my heart really broke. Especially when I saw faces I could recognize. I saw that people had gassed out. Truly. Mothers who used to have a very strong prayer altar, I saw the thing going down. Usually it starts through carelessness. Here and there. Even if you don't pray 1 week, it doesn't matter. There's grace for me. I'll come again. And then before you know it, completely void of power. And you know the interesting thing? No matter how bad you are, the devil will never strike you. He's smart. If he strikes you, you will go for a retreat very fast. And you will come back. So he will allow you to keep moving. There is a threshold level. It's like a gauge in the spirit. You keep going down, he will not strike. Keep going down. One day he will aim at you. And if not for the mercy of God and the prophetic, he will hit you bad.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God.
Hallelujah. I will share with you three keys the Lord revealed to me. That if not managed, will strengthen the power of darkness to cause the havoc that it plans to cause. Take note of this month, July. You see, this month, July, there is intense warfare going on in the realm of the spirit. Those who are sensitive know. Those who are not sensitive just assume and move carelessly and foolishly until they become victims. This month, mark this month, July, you see, is a month of intense spiritual building. You need to build capacity for the months to come. Victory is assured, but the strength of many will be tested in the months to come. You will see this happen. The strength of men of God, the strength of people, their spiritual capacity will be tested. And only those who have built fortification in the spirit. The Bible says for us to redeem the time. Take advantage of the time. Are we together? So the devil is attacking the prayer lives of people. Dramatically. You see, he's not attacking it by stopping you from praying. I will show you the things. The first thing that the devil is using to sabotage the prophetic advancement of believers and the church, listen, is exhaustion. The reality of the weariness of our bodies. The reality of that weariness. Exhaustion. Psychological exhaustion. Physical exhaustion. Are we together? So when people gas out, they come to a point where it no longer makes sense to wait upon the Lord and trust the Lord. Because many hopes have been disappointed. Many dreams seemingly look like they are shattered. People look at their experience versus their prophecy and it does not match. And so many are fainting, including the great ones who should stand to strengthen many people. And there's nothing to be embarrassed there. That's why God is opening us up to it, so that we will rise. Is God blessing us? Exhaustion. Weariness. That fatigue. That spiritual fatigue where you want to study your Bible and you just look at it and it looks like a burden. You want to open your Bible and study, it looks like a burden. You buy books but you don't read them. You buy DVDs but you can't watch them. There seems to be a spirit that takes advantage of our humanity and our weariness. So you are buying books, you are buying tapes, you are downloading messages. Those around will think you are taking advantage of them, but you know that it's been a long time since you made contact with these resources. Not because you are not of God. It's called weariness, exhaustion. Even the young men shall faint and the youth will utterly fall, he says. That's the first thing that I saw that the devil is taking advantage of to destroy people. Just destroy people. Just destroy people. The second thing that the Lord revealed to me is financial limitation. Write it down. I saw a lot of people whose focus had been distracted, and the reason was because there were no resources. I saw churches, groups, people, even people who used to participate actively in the house of God, prayer meetings, prayer groups, the reality of the stress and strain that lack of finances brings. A lot of people started asking themselves questions. Look, we're humans. Let's go and solve our family needs first. And it's a plot. It's a plot by darkness. Are we together? Where believers go to pray and they can't pray because of financial weariness. And even if they pray, the entire circumference of their prayer is lamentation and a plea for open heavens. You may not realize it, but it's a strategy. It's a strategy. Listen, let me tell you something. Satan weighs the governments of nations like a treasure on a balance and manipulates them according to his desire. This thing called mammon is Satan's weapon of mass destruction. Mammon, that spirit, the only spirit that Jesus taught that you can worship either him or that spirit. He never said Satan. He said you cannot serve two masters. So in any way, your servanthood must be registered either to God or to mammon. Hallelujah. In that vision, I saw people losing jobs, companies downsizing people. There are not many times you hear me speak prophetically like this, but you write it and see. I saw it happening to people. Are we together? Several people confused. Even, do you know that pastors and churches went down financially because their members didn't have the means, you know, offerings and tithes and all of that, and it was a weariness to people. And subtly, the teachings about spiritual growth, the teachings about empowerment, intimacy, encounter began to diminish because the pastors were forced to have to continue talking about finances. It became as though it was the only key that will have to keep the people coming to the churches. Are we together? When I saw this thing, my heart dropped. And I said, my God, what is this? You have to do something about this nonsense, because the devil wants to take advantage of the economic tide that is sweeping Africa and that spirit that is sweeping Nigeria. That bitterness, that offense. Many people no longer pay attention to God. You meet somebody and talk to him about spiritual growth, and the person will even tell you to go away. Why? Because we have said it unapologetically in this ministry that when your finances is not secured, it will affect your spiritual life. There's no confusion about it. I hope you believe what I'm sharing with you. Oh, please, you better do. Please, you better do. Because it will happen. The third thing I saw was, it's like flies. You know how house flies? Like a swarm of flies. Now, there are times I've seen these things prophetically and I've shared them here over. But I saw a swarm of flies just coming across regions. And I looked at it and the Lord took my mind back to the plague, one of the plague that happened in the days of Moses, when the swamp of flies came around and began to consume people. And I had in my spirit the ministry of the devourer, manifesting as sicknesses, manifesting as tragic events, and ultimately death. I saw this thing. Rampant manifestation of mysterious sicknesses that cannot be diagnosed in hospitals. They will check you with machines and say nothing is happening.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of our God. Blessed are you, for you come in the name of our God.
I'm not a prophet of doom. But I saw the tears in Nigeria in the month of September. It was almost unbearable. Just listen to me, I've not finished preaching. I'm not a prophet of doom, but I saw it was bad economically and otherwise. It was like this country was completely clueless and at a point of a mess. I saw people being laid off from work. Completely laid off. Husbands, wives, laid off. Their services were no longer needed in different sectors, including government sectors. They downsized people because they needed to accommodate what was happening. Are we together? I saw an increase in crime rate, theft, stealing, including stealing people, not just stealing things, stealing people. Why is God revealing this? To scare you? No. God is revealing this to strengthen you. He will never bring a prophecy without a strategy. Just keep following. There is always an exemption for the church. But the problem most times is we don't pay attention. There are people who hear what I'm saying now. I'm sorry, especially for elderly people. They just shut down and say, all these idiots talking again. And then until it happens, and then we become victims of situations and circumstances. You see, let me tell you something. Prophecy in its purest form was designed not just to give people, to make people privy to something that will happen. The most important part of prophecy is the strategy for exemption. Not what will happen, the strategy for exemption. Any true prophet that brings a word from the Lord, especially if it's a word that is on the negative side, if it came from God, God must be able to speak to his people and say, this is a strategy. You can choose it, especially for certain things that are written judgments. You cannot pray them away, but there is a system. Like the flood of Noah, there was a system that was built called the ark. Like the passing of the angel of death upon Egypt, the mystery of the blood of the lamb and the Passover, right? It was the mystery of exemption. But you see, the church, we have this ugly mentality which came from a misguided understanding of what the New Testament teaches. I can relate with God. I don't need to hear anybody. Leave me alone. If it's so, God will speak to me. If God has not spoken to me, I will not listen. Let me tell you something. Listen, I was teaching the school of ministry students. Our spiritual growth is based on our personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. But the advancement of the kingdom is based on covenants. You have to understand this. Your spiritual growth and my spiritual growth is based on my personal encounter, my knowledge of who God is, his ways, and that's how I grow. In the Old Testament, it used to be through prophets and mediums, but now the Bible tells us that Jesus has come as a mediator. He's opened a new and living way to all of us. We can now access God directly in terms of spiritual growth. But the advancement of God's kingdom is not general. God finds men and enters a covenant with those men to represent his dealings in a particular dimension. And every time God wants to deal with a territory in that dimension, it must come through those channels. They are called spiritual tribes. They represent the communication of God's purposes in a dimension. So when you talk about faith, Every time God wants to bring his speakings as regards the word of faith, there are spiritual channels he has entered a personal covenant with and aligned them to be able to communicate his purposes in that respect. Bishop Oyedepo, Kenneth Copeland, you can trace that spiritual tribe and they represent his communications in that regard. Are we together? There are other dimensions. When the spirit of revival wants to fall upon the nation, there are people who represent the spiritual tribe that communicates that reality to the world. It's not general. So you're tapping into that possibility only becomes on the strength of your alignment with what God is doing. When God wants to come in the area of finances and prosperity, I know that everyone will be blessed, but there are people who have a personal covenant with God that represent his speakings in that regard. You will never ignore their ministry and hear the current dealings of the Spirit as far as that is concerned. So the advancement of the kingdom is not based on personal relationship. It's based on covenants. God calls a man called Abraham, the first man in the Bible who showed us that men can walk by faith with God. Are we together? He is God's type of faith. The only reason why we can tap into the possibilities of God as far as the blessing is concerned is on the strength of the covenant that God entered with one man called Abraham. Are we together? When God wanted to salvage a nation, he used one man called Moses, entered a personal covenant with Moses that afforded Moses an unusual access to God beyond his personal spiritual growth, because Moses himself did not make the cut to the promised land. How be it based on that covenant? To an extent that although Moses may have failed spiritually, in the book of Jude, an angel came to carry.
Dearly beloved, I hope you were blessed by this message. I want you to keep doing something for this man of God, our man of God, Apostle Joshua Selman. And that is, I want you to keep on praying for him, that the cause of the gospel may have free flow in him, that he may be granted boldness to continue with his commission of Jesus Christ, and that all provisions be given unto him as he continues in this journey of Christianity. And then, don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you are new here. Don't also forget to leave a comment in the comment section, and then keep sharing abroad, and let's all keep sharing Jesus. I'll see you again